regardless of how much punishment you've taken, you can lift 35 pounds real fast with adrenaline.
Two terrific original six teams played a great final. Let's have a big hand for the Boston Bruins and the Chicago Blackhawks. The Blackhawks started with 24 games unbeaten this season, and this is their second Stanley Cup in 4 years. A great organization led by Rocky Works, John McDonough, Joel Quenneville, Stan Bowman, the entire organization, but most importantly, the fans and these great players. Jonathan Toews, you have the honor of hoisting the Stanley Cup.
The pose, and now the raise. Always curious as to whom it will go first. And there is the answer. Michael Hanzus, one of the elder statesmen, on a rather young team. And he'll move it along.
I'd imagine he's going to give it to Jamal Mayers at some point. I'd be shocked if he isn't the next guy.
You are correct, sir.
15th year in the National Hockey League. Jamal Mayers was a key figure back in round two when the Blackhawks were down 3-1 to the Detroit Red Wings. It was Mayers who spoke loudly in a meeting, and the Blackhawks with that unbelievable comeback against the Detroit Red Wings to win in game seven in overtime.
If you count a game of 60 minutes, the two teams that battled in this played over seven games, not six. Conn Smythe Trophy winner Patrick Kane is with Pierre.
Thanks very much, Doc. Conn Smythe Trophy winner, was that part of the repertoire growing up in Buffalo?
You know, I think there's a lot of guys that deserved it. I think Crow might have got snubbed, to be honest with you, but I tell you what, it's a hell of an achievement. I think it speaks more for my team than myself personally. Playing with great players, it was the best year of my life, just playing with these guys. You know, starting off the season like we did with so many wins, and the pressure of winning the President's Trophy and hanging on to that pressure all the way to the end. You know, you're down 2-1 in the last minutes, and then you come through with the 3-2 win. I mean, it's unbelievable.
What was going on during those last 2 minutes on your bench and on the ice?
I think we just wanted to get it in their end and try to get a shot on net and crash the net and see what happened. On the second goal, Johnny made a great pass to Bix. Bix with the huge playoffs too, you know, finishes it off, make it 2-2, and then we kept the momentum. Dave Bolin, I mean, what else can you say about that guy? He shows up in big playoff games, so it's a great feeling.
Congratulations, go hoist that cup for the second time. Well earned, Patrick.
All right, number two.
Doc.
Victor Stahlberg has just handed it off. And Brian Bickle raises it high.
What a playoff for Bickle. Had 9 goals in the regular season. He ended up with 9 goals in the postseason. A huge game-tying goal with the extra attacker on the ice off the great play from Jonathan Toews to lift up the stick of David Krejci to create space. And the rest is history after David Bolin with the game-winning goal.
Patrick Sharp, one of 5 Catamounts of Vermont to win the Stanley Cup.
How about the game of Duncan Keith? He has a Stanley Cup trophy right now. What a playoff for him, Doc. Became a father for the first time. His wife, Kelly Ray, gave birth to his son, Colton. And he played an unbelievable game. He was one of the key cogs here tonight in game 6.
Well, let's hear from the goaltender, Misters Crawford and McGuire.
Thanks very much, Doc. You had a great view of the David Bowling goal. How'd it look from your end of the ice?
Awesome. I still can't believe that finish. Oh my God, we never quit. This feels unbelievable. Amazing, man.
Corey, you did never quit. But the last time you were in this building, it was a rough game. Your confidence was sketchy. How'd you get it back?
Never lost confidence. Nobody in our room ever did. All year, all playoffs, we're all behind each other. It was a hell of an effort by everyone, man. Unbelievable.
How did you guys get so mentally strong over the course of the year? Because you had the long winning streak, you had to come from behind against Detroit, you had a battle in this series, an amazingly difficult thing. How are you guys so mentally strong?
We just kept telling ourselves to keep playing our game, keep going like that, and we'll give ourselves a great chance. And we did that all year long.
So I asked this question to Jonathan Toews in 2010. I'll ask it of you. You've battled hard to get into this league. What's a view like now that you got the Stanley Cup by your side?
It's unbelievable, man. So much hard work to get to this point, and a great effort by everyone together as a team. And it feels so good right now.
Yeah.
Thank you. Congratulations, and have a great summer, Corey.
Nice talking. Nice play.
As they discovered in Boston, the course of a game can change so quickly. And this one changed in the last minute 16 of regulation.
Corey Crawford on the bench for the extra attacker. Jonathan Toews lifts up the stick